living large and taking charge, big boy.
Listen up, it's Danny and Tay, and we are heard. Hi guys, welcome back to episode 85 of Heard the Podcast. This is Danny.
And it's Taylor.
And you can listen to Heard the Podcast on all podcast streaming platforms. And you can follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Heard the Podcast, H-E-R-D the Podcast. And you can also subscribe to our YouTube channel, H-E-R apostrophe D the Podcast. All right, so I'm definitely going to talk about this whole like Danny Lay thing.
Yeah.
Definitely going to do that. Yes. But before that, one thing that I wanted to say, though, that was kind of, like, annoying. What? Just real quick. So I don't understand why y'all go on Instagram Live with someone and y'all have, like, 2 to 3, like, viewers. And y'all be having full-blown convos with the person.
When nobody's watching.
And, like, no one's watching and there's, like, personal convos. Like, y'all can't just go on FaceTime. Like, it's just, I don't understand why you got to have a convo with somebody on Instagram Live with 2 other viewers.
It's about, I don't really care. It's my damn life.
You're not talking. I don't understand.
And I wasn't watching, so I don't.
But I clicked on it just to see what was going on, and I'm just like,
what was the whole point?
But like, why y'all on the phone? Y'all on the phone on Instagram?
That's pretty much what it is. Like, what? Y'all could have did FaceTime.
Yeah, FaceTime. Real quick. Like, y'all clearly know each other. Y'all over here catching up.
That's with what people who can't, like, if I don't have your number, and we, you know what I'm saying? That's different.
But y'all catching up. Y'all childhood friends catching up. So y'all got to have some sort of, like, communication. Like, it's exhausting a little bit. It's exhausting. You know what? I don't really have too many, like, things on my list, but, like, the things that I have on my list are loaded, if that makes sense.
Yeah. It's a lot. It's going to be a lot said, but it's not that many topics.
Yeah, so we haven't recorded since the inauguration, have we?
No. That was before.
Okay, so how do you feel, though, about everything? I definitely stayed my ass out of D.C., stayed my ass right on the Maryland side.
I was in the
side,
house watching it.
Right on the Peachtree County side, right on the
even
side.
Days leading up to it, I stayed my ass in the house.
Stayed my ass right in the motherfucking house.
Because, like, my friend had to go get her back, my job made her go get the background check, like, the day before the inauguration or a few days before, and some white people ended up chasing her and hopped out some vans and started chasing her.
Oh, my
her.
God.
Yes. Now, on Pennsylvania Avenue, somewhere. Where,
oh.
Or something, like, somewhere down that way. But she was running like shit. And she got varicose veins, so her legs be hurting.
Oh.
So she was made of shit. And she ended up finding some police and they helped her. But like, she was being chased.
The hell?
I was like, what the fuck?
Oh Lord.
And she was just trying to get back in the house.
But so let's just get into this thing. So did you see what was going on with Danny Lay?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh
so,
my God, yes.
She really did spark a lot of controversy and a lot of conversation. But before I get into all that, so Danny Lay, she went on Instagram and she posted some clip of some fucking rough draft of a song.
It was horrible.
It was horrible. But it was like
horrible.
It was called Yellow Bone, and she was just saying like, Yellow Bone is what he want. What he want?
Yes,
Yellow Bone is what he want. So I'm just like, what? So first, this is, I'm gonna come clean. So when I first scrolled and saw it, I was like, huh? And I just kept scrolling, right?
Mm-hmm.
So then I was on Twitter and I noticed that she was trending. And so when I saw how she was trending, there was, you know, saying like how, like, you know, she made a song about being like a yellow bone and saying that's what he wants or whatever the fuck. And so people were upset about that. People were bringing up valid points. And then her reaction was like, how come I can't make a song about being, about my light-skinned baddies, you know, for my light-skinned
yeah,
baddies.
I saw that.
Why y'all so sensitive? It's not that deep. I'm just saying that's what he wants, not the world, da-da-da-da-da, right? Whatever. Whatever. The whole typical defense thing. And so when I looked deeper into it, because I didn't think about it at all. Because I'm like, I don't care about this dumb. The shit was dumb. It sounded horrible. I just kept scrolling. I'm like, what is
this?
That's
the thing. It's not even a good song.
Auto-tune bullshit. So, yeah, I looked into it. She was trending. And, you know, it sparked the whole conversation of colorism and things like that. And so that's when I got deeper into it. And rightfully so, honestly. With this whole Danny Lay thing, I think that, first of all, the song, it sounded like a rough cut. Like, it was just like she did
yes.
it real quick. So, I think, to me, you know, one of the things that was said was that she was trying to take a shot at Mimi, the baby's baby mother,
yes.
who's like a chocolate, a beautiful chocolate woman. And honestly, I low-key think it was a shot at her.
I do 100%. Because I'm
like, so what was the point of this song? Why make this song? Talking
about I'm what he want.
Like, I don't get it. Like, what was the purpose of it?
It's annoying because don't sit here and just, like, first of all, it's a mother of his fucking kids. And when he not with you, he be wanting his baby mother any fucking way.
She played it off as if she wasn't trying to.
Yeah, but everybody knows that's what the case was, bitch.
Because this is my thing, right? I think, with Dani Leigh, because the whole situation of her and the baby is just real clownish to me. Because he literally was with his baby mother on Instagram.
Like, right before you.
Four weeks before he, like, claimed you publicly.
Right.
And I thought it was clownish because of that. And then also, right when they had broken up. Girl, she'd been in the picture for a while now, to my understanding. But when they, like, broke up, him and Dani, I remember on Instagram, she posted some picture of some clouds, and she wrote, like, saying, like, I know I'm a good girlfriend, and I'm going to land, and I'm going to start fresh, and I'm going to start new, and I'm going to whatever. So it was some little think piece that she wrote about being heartbroken or whatever. But she ended up getting back with the baby. But anywho, that's why I've made it clownish to me. But then also, you know, they're known to, like, have gone back and forth on social media as well.
Yeah.
So my whole thing is, like, I think that Dani, you know, this is just me. Look, I'm just talking shit. It's my podcast, whatever. So I think that she constantly, you know, I guess, questions her place with him, I guess. Because for one, like, literally they were on Instagram together 4 weeks before he claimed you. Like, literally a month before, he was with it, tonguing down his baby mother, Mimi. Mm-hmm. Then that next month, he was claiming you on Instagram. Because I guess, I don't know, maybe Mimi broke up
for
with him.
Now.
I don't know. But, and that's what Mimi says. She says, for now, like, girl, I gave him to you. Like, I gave him up. He chose me, but he settled for you type shit. And honestly, like, I think it's low-key true. Like, it's weird that you posted this fucking think piece in the clouds and saying, like, how you're going to reset your life or whatever the fuck. But then I guess when he breaks up with his baby mother, you want to swoop in. Like, it was just the whole thing was
if his baby mother called him back right now, or no, if they never broke up, him and his baby mother, mm-hmm. you would, like, it wouldn't even be no the baby and her.
From the looks of things, they were him and Dani Leigh were messing around, you know, before.
Yeah,
like, and
he just wasn't claiming her to
exactly.
The public.
Like, he didn't choose you first. You know what I'm saying? He was with baby mother.
Exactly. So they just make her look stupid. That whole situation made her look stupid.
It was
anyway.
Really weird and goofy to me. Because I'm like,
I'm not about to be nobody's second choice.
Because, like, she's posted up with him saying, this is my baby, I don't care, this is my baby, I don't care, this and that. And just telling us all your business. And then when we sit here and bring up shit with the information that you've given us, you're upset and saying that we're being sensitive and being whatever.
You put it out there, babe.
But, yeah, I think it was a shot at the baby mother, honestly. Because I'm just like, because my whole thing is, I think it's a shot because, okay, she's so beautiful, she's this. All right, well, fine, I'm light skinned, so I'm gonna just use this as my thing that's like a token for me or whatever the fuck. But no, like, because you're offending his baby mothers. Because, like, first of all, both his baby mothers are chocolate, beautiful and chocolate.
Beautiful.
But he has dark skinned kids, so you're offending
all of these baby, people.
Yeah.
People.
Yeah. So I see it as that, honestly, I do. So.
And then how you trying to represent your light skinned baddies or whatever? But who the fuck wants you to represent them? Putting that shit out and then. Pretty much bring it down anybody else that's darker than that with this stupid ass song. This song sounds horrible. It's trash.
It was horrible. Yeah, that's what I think. I think she got mad. I think she got mad one day. She probably saw some text messages that she wasn't supposed to see. And she got mad. Was like, fuck this shit. Yellow bonus, buddy. Whoa, what he wants. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, she
and
got
called it a day.
Yeah. Because I don't think that was not a real song.
It's not like she recorded it on
real
SoundCloud.
Quick,
or
she was mad. I don't think that was a real song.
It's like some
at
SoundCloud
all.
Shit. I'm so serious.
But anywho, so she was like, why can't I do this? People make songs about all skin tones all the time or whatever, whatever. So back to the whole colorism thing. So this whole thing happened like Thursday. So it's been going on since Thursday. So it sparked a whole uproar of colorism topics. And honestly, like, I'm really proud of us that we denounce certain things. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm really happy that just us as Black women, we have, you know, we hold up that platform, and we're bigger and we're stronger in numbers, and we literally denounce. She released a fucking video apology last night.
Yeah, no one cares.
Yeah, so we, but yeah, like I love how we all came together and just like denounced it, and like we created a discourse, and we discussed it. I don't accept
that apology. It was not even a good apology.
And we called her out.
It was not even a real apology.
It was very much like PR, like her record label. So
yeah, and it was just like, that's not what I meant. That's how y'all took it. That's not what I meant.
Because like, we're her audience. Den Lee, she's popular. But she's not like a mainstream, like pop girl.
No. Nope.
Like, I think her main audience is people of color.
Yes.
And she needs us on her side when it comes to her success.
Yeah, so why would you want to fuck
consuming
that?
Her stuff? But yeah, so I appreciate what the conversation brought. There were a lot of Clubhouse conversations. And I think this weekend really, like, Clubhouse really served its purpose this weekend, for sure. Like, it was very much some good content this weekend. Because other days, it's like, oh, do you like cum in your mouth? Or do you like this
you
nasty
never know what
shit?
You're going to get.
Yeah, like, you know what I'm saying? So this weekend really brought out good content. And I love how it had, you know, black women speaking on the situation, black men speaking on the situation. Because honestly, like, you know, of course, colorism, it started with slavery. And like, you know, it's still alive and well when it comes to commercials and things like that. You know, this false sense of European standard of beauty. Mm-hmm. But, you know, it's also within us. Like, you know, we perpetuate that stigma within ourselves, you know. Yeah. So you know, we divide ourselves when we say, oh, you got good hair, you got bad hair, oh, you got pretty skin, you mix,
so good,
you know. Yeah, I understand, but you know, that's what we do amongst ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to get too deep into it, but I just think that it really brought really good conversations, and I'm really happy of, you know, I'm really happy that, you know, everyone's talking about it. And I was just in the Clubhouse today with the game. And, you know, I'm glad that a rapper like him is, like, starting those convos and, like, allowing people on different platforms to, like, be heard.
Yeah, because everybody's going to go in that shit.
Because, you know, another thing about rappers and stuff, you know, we were just talking about how Lil Wayne and 50 Cent said they little ignorant ass shit. You know, a lot of times with rappers, they have those, like, racially, quote-unquote, exotic girls in their videos in the forefront, and they push the dark girls in. Oh, you might not even have a dark girl at all in the video, you know? So it's definitely, like it brings, you know, it's all in commercials and music videos and all those things. So I'm really happy, you know, and I think King Los was in that Clubhouse room today too. Yeah, Jason Lee was in the Clubhouse room. All the people were in the Clubhouse room talking about it and just like bringing awareness to it and like, where can we
go
from here? Where can we go
from here? Type of thing. To do good.
Yeah. But I was a little disappointed though. Oh, which are also too, shout out to Meth Eater, M-E-F Eater, the magazine platform and, you know, digital content platform.
Yes.
I was in one of their Clubhouses the other day during the weekend. That was really cool. I really love the platform that they have. I really love Meth Eater and what they stand for. It's M-E-F Eater on Instagram and Twitter. Y'all should go follow if y'all don't.
They're amazing.
But I was a little disappointed, though, regarding this conversation. I will shout out Chica, though, the rapper Chica,
C-H-I-K-A.
She said something to Dana Lay on Twitter because she was trending. She was like, yeah, because, you know, Dana Lay, of course, she was taking offense and saying, oh, y'all are taking it out of proportion. I'm Dominican, da, da, da. You know, because, girl.
You're Dominican.
That's another thing, too. I gotta get into that.
You're Dominican.
I gotta get into that real quick.
Okay, you're Dominican.
I gotta get into that real quick too, but
yes.
let me just, I'm trying to like unravel this in like a nice, graceful way. So yeah, Chica called her out on it, you know, cause Dana Lay was, you know, saying, oh, y'all, it's one more thing that y'all can hate on me about. Y'all can't cancel me. God can only cancel me, this and that, blah, blah, blah.
Girl, shut the fuck
and
up.
So Chica was like, you know, everyone is having, we're criticizing you this is all valid criticism.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we're all upset because for valid reasons, you know. She said that Karen Civil was like, this song should have been left in the trash.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it was just
even
it
after,
was just
after
very
that,
much that.
Even after that apology video, people in the comments were like, we don't accept your apology and that song is trash.
Yeah, because, you know, before she was...
Nobody accepted it.
Because before she was saying, y'all are being sensitive and I can't make a song about being light-skinned. I'm not downing anybody else. I'm just saying about being light-skinned.
Yeah, then she gives a half-assed apology.
Because she had to.
I know, but it was half-assed. If you're going to do it right.
We didn't believe it.
I can't stand half-assed. If you're going to apologize, fully apologize. Don't. If it's going to be half-assed, just don't even bother.
Wait, what made it half-assed to you?
I didn't feel that she was sorry or any of that. I didn't feel any of it.
I think she was sorry.
I think she was sorry that people are mad. Mm-hmm. I don't think she takes back anything in that song. I don't think she really feels bad. I think she feels bad she offended people.
I think that she, her making that song was just very insecure of her. It was very much insecure. What was the point of you making that song?
I don't think
song?
She thought she was going to offend people and things like that. I don't think she thought of it in that way. So I think she was sorry for offending
it's
people.
It's another way of you throwing your relationship with the baby in our face, but for what? Yeah. Because you get upset when people criticize
she
you.
She was being petty. And that's
yeah,
what
she
was.
I think she was.
Petty.
You can't 100% tell me she, being you petty. Can't tell me she wasn't. Like, what was the point of this? And the thing is, the clip did not sound like a real song. It sounded like she went in the studio because she was mad, because she saw some text messages.
Real quick, and just like, it don't sound like it was edited, mastered, anything. She just like, she just did like one
because
take, that's
the
bet.
Like,
put
I
it
feel
out
like
there.
If Mimi was light-skinned, I don't think that she would have made that song.
No. She wouldn't have.
It wouldn't be, and it wouldn't
and
have
if
been,
she made a song, it wouldn't have been nothing
have,
about being light-skinned.
It wouldn't
all.
Have been nothing that you could stand out about with that. If you see what I'm saying.
Yeah. I agree.
Why I think she made the song. Because it's like, yeah. you're trying to,
that's the
you're
one
trying
thing
to point
you can
out,
say to her.
You're trying to point out the difference between you and her.
Yeah.
Which
that's
is weird
what
as fuck.
Girl, shut the fuck up. If yeah. he want, like, he clearly don't just want all light-skinned bitches because look at the mother of his kids, the mothers of his kids. Like,
yeah.
You acting like that's all he in the market for is a damn light-skinned girl. Girl, shut the hell up. You will not be the last.
No, she's not.
She won't.
She's not even the one now.
She's
shit.
Girl, he's only with you because his baby mother don't want him right now. That's it. If they were still together, there would be no y'all going public and all that. It would have still been behind the scenes.
Because it was really weird. And the thing is, like, you don't feel clownish that you posted that picture with him literally, like, a month after, like, they were tongue each other down on Instagram Live? Like, you don't feel like feel like a clownish about that? Like, you look real pressed. You look pressed as fuck. Mm-hmm. You look real pressed.
You look real stupid.
And the thing is, too, when people call... Another thing about these rappers and singers and celebrities and stuff, when people call... When we call you out on certain things, we're not being sensitive. We're not hate. Everything is not hate towards you.
No. We're telling you
everything
what the fuck
is not hate towards you. All of these things that we said over the weekend about colorism and racism and separation and light skin, red bone, yellow bone, blue bone, whatever the fuck, everything that was said was valid as fuck.
Very valid. Everything. Because I was reading comments.
Let me get into this real quick, because I'm going to get into the whole Dominican stuff a little bit. But
it's
anyway,
just a lot.
So I was a little upset though with the Breakfast Club, because they discussed it on their show the other day. And this is the thing, right? I enjoy the Breakfast Club, like, you know, as a whole, and I enjoy Charlamagne, I enjoy all of them.
Yeah.
But sometimes when it comes to different subjects, especially black subjects, when it comes to women and colorism and racism, things like that, I don't think that they really dive in properly, or it'll be Charlamagne dismissing it, and like I feel like Angela Lee don't really be going hard enough. Like, you can tell Angela Yee, she has good sense, but she don't go hard enough when it comes to, like, combating Charlamagne or Envy when they're ignorant about certain things.
I agree with that.
Because it's not just about colorism or whatever. It'll be about somebody up there being a trans guest or whatever. They'll say some ignorant ass shit, but then Angela will sit there and not say nothing too much. You know, like, I don't like that shit.
I agree with that 100%. And I don't even watch every interview they do or every mm-hmm. episode they have.
Catch clips.
Clips, or if it's somebody on there that I'm interested in seeing, of mm-hmm. course I'm going to watch it. But I have noticed that now that you bring it up, she's not combative enough at all. And
like, I don't want you to scream and yell and be aggressive, but like, give us some more.
You can say something.
She says something, but it'd be like some soft, like little vague, not too much. You know, it don't really be strong enough for me. It don't be strong enough for me.
A minute, it'd be fine.
But I was disappointed because I felt like Charlamagne was dismissing it. Like, he was saying, like, oh, I don't see what the problem is. As long as she ain't downing brown girls, I don't see what the problem is or whatever. Like, what's that? I don't get it. I don't understand. Then he was saying, like, you know, Beyonce made a song called Brown Skin Girl. Why ain't nobody mad about that? Rappers rap about light skin girls all the time. This and that, this and that.
Because
so
brown
this, so
this
is the this
a
is
wide
the thing.
Range.
This is the thing. No, this is the thing. Beyonce made a song about uplifting brown skin girls because we're brown girls are the oppressed. Light-skinned girls are always light-skinned girls and Latinas, they're always praised and uplifted. So you're going to uplift the oppressed, just like how we have Black History
That's
Month.
The whole
Why do we have
point.
Black History Month? Because we were oppressed.
We were oppressed,
and we want to highlight our excellence. But even though that damn month is some
we get the shortest month of the damn year.
But you know what I'm saying? But like, he was saying things like that, dismissing it. But the thing is with Beyonce, first of all, Beyonce did the right thing because Beyonce is a light-skinned woman. and she benefits from light skin privilege. And she made a song uplifting brown skin girls. She had Kelly in there. She had Naomi Campbell in there. She had all the brown girls in there, uplifting them, giving them the spotlight, telling them that their skin is beautiful. So you using that
That's two different things.
You using that as an example to like dismiss what Danielle did doesn't make any sense. It's like y'all just be spitting shit out and don't even be making no fucking sense.
They don't
sense.
Even know what the fuck
But
about.
You know what I'm saying? Even like she, you know, like even her father, Beyonce's father, Matthew Knowles, he said that Beyonce benefits
off
like,
and that.
She does.
He did say that.
The thing is with Beyonce, it's cool. Benefit from whatever you want to benefit, because at the end of the day, her work speaks for herself. So
she can be light skinned. All the brown girls. So
her being light skinned, yeah, she gets privileges, but rightfully so, because she's the most hardworking. She produces the highest quality of content.
Yes.
So you know. Beyonce deserves everything that she gets, all of the accolades that she gets. She deserves it. But what she did was she used her light skin privilege, her privilege to uplift brown girls. That's what she fucking did.
That's two different things. So don't sit there and compare that.
To do.
But don't compare that to what the hell Danny Lay did.
Because it was no point. The song. It was just. I don't even I will always say this. There was no purpose of this.
It was not.
Why was this even a thing? It was that. And
it's like she
also
made a song in 5 minutes.
They love to bring up the brown skin girl song, and then they also brought up. Oh well, Childish Gambino has a song called Redbone. First of all, once again, y'all spitting shit out y'all mouth. If y'all listen to Childish Gambino's song, he's not uplifting light skin girl. He's telling a fucking story. He's just singing about what the fuck. I don't even think that he even said Redbone in the damn song.
He didn't at all.
So
that's what I'm saying.
He could have named the damn song Toothpicks, and it's still been the same song. It don't matter. What he does is symbolic. You know, it's just and this is the same nigga that said that made the song called This Is America. So why would he make a song about?
Thank you.
It don't make no sense.
Thank
and then
you.
Also,
thank you.
Y'all love to bring up, rappers do this all the time. Rappers say da-da-da-da-da.
But we talk about that. Like, any shit Lil Wayne, listen, anybody, that shit gets brought up and niggas speak on it.
Yeah.
So don't act like we only just attacking you
exactly.
And coming for you, because that's not the case.
Exactly.
Nowadays, we have social media, and everybody speaks up, whether they have a big platform, small platform, everybody speaks up and says what they have to say about whoever said what. So you are not being attacked, baby girl.
And even if we did, if we didn't speak on the rappers that say certain things, a lot of them rappers wouldn't have none of them bitches if they weren't rich, if they weren't rappers.
Listen, if Lil Wayne was not a rich ass rapper, no, he would, listen, he would not get all these bitches. I'm sorry. A lot of these motherfuckers. 50 Cent too.
Yeah, so like I said, this whole subject matter brought up a lot of things. One of the things they had trending was that Just Britney girl. I think she's a singer or a rapper or whatever. So I guess
I
she was on.
That girl.
So have you ever watched that VH1 show called Signed? I never watched
That's
it.
That's how I found out about her.
Yeah, she was on it. I never watched it, though.
She, to me, and I'm not trying to discredit her, because, like, you know, she's doing her thing or whatever. Mm-hmm. And I can't say I really was a fan of her music, but whatever. But she ended up being one of the people that got signed. But to me,
won.
No, I think they ended up giving her like a little side deal or something like that. I forgot what happened.
Oh, so there wasn't a winner?
I think it was because Rick Ross. Yeah, there was a winner, but Rick Ross decided to like sign her to his label.
That's not against the contract? They can do that on those types of shows?
Like, he can do what he want with his own label, I guess, so they let him do it.
Oh,
but
because
I want to say it was, what's the name show? The Dream's actual show. But I mean, I guess he let him do it as his label. He gave her like, it wasn't even like, I don't even think she was fully signed. I think he like,
no, so that's what I'm saying. Like, when you're a guest judge on shows like that, like, don't you sign a contract of saying like you can't take them, because that's you discovered them on your platform. So wouldn't VH1 get a cut of that if you did decide to sign them on the side? That's what I'm saying.
I don't know how it worked. And what he just, I think he gave her like however much money to do whatever in the studio. Like on his dime or something like that to help her out. I don't think he like officially, like, she's not signed to
Maybach,
yeah. But on the show, he liked her and said he gonna flirt with her.
So that was
like
the whole thing.
So
yeah,
that's
so,
what I think it came
So that was
from.
The whole thing. So that clip, it was a clip of Just Britney. She
I
was
love
singing
that show.
She was singing in front of Rick Ross, The Dream, and some other guy. And it was there were other girls in the room too competing. And so she sang, and you know, it wasn't really as good as the girl that came after her, a browner girl that came after her. She blew the roof off. I saw the clip. She could sing. And so it clearly shows that Rick Ross was interested in her looks.
Yeah. She's a lighter skinned girl. And, you know, she bought curvy. She got a booty. Yeah. She got fake booty.
And all the niggas, because the thing is, it was niggas. It was Rick Ross and other niggas that were like the people in power to like, you know, to choose whoever was going to be the winner of the challenge or whatever.
Yeah.
So it was them. They all, Rick Ross, the dream all of them, was sitting there just fucking drooling over this girl.
Yeah.
This girl singing off key and they sitting there just drooling over her. Just yes. Looking and bobbing their head.
It was all about her looks. And that's kind of, I'm not going to say I can't stand her. That was kind of mean.
Because, no, because she went on Instagram and made it, she said, you know, this clip has been going around and I agree. You know, I do have privileges because I'm light skinned and this and that. My looks or whatever do allow me to have certain privileges. She agreed. She said
okay, well,
so she acknowledged
that's why it. I said, it means I can't stand her, but yeah. I didn't like how that happened on the show. I just felt like y'all just paying more attention to this girl. Because it was other girls that were really, really, really talented.
And you can clearly see the difference.
But they didn't
you
have a fake butt and this and that.
You can clearly
and
see the difference of how Rick Ross interacted with the other girls, like especially the one that came after just Britney. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, the girl could clearly sing. He sat there, you know, she could clearly sing, but she just wasn't eye candy for them, I guess. Yeah. So that's why they didn't really react the same way.
Yeah, but it's not fair.
They
talent
reacted to the girl before.
You cannot take talent from somebody.
Yeah.
If this bitch can sing, this bitch can sing. So I didn't like that. But I did really like the show. I liked the show from the talent, but more so, it was the comedic relief was Rick Ross, of course.
Oh, really?
Have little jokes and stuff on it. So Rick Ross is just, I think his personality is just like, he'd be on joke time a lot. So that was funny to watch. I wonder what happened with another season because I would have watched it.
Oh, I don't even know. Because I think BT had a show like that too called The Next Big Thing.
Yeah, I didn't watch that one.
I watched it.
I only watched The Sign because it was Rick Ross.
Mm-hmm.
And The Dream, like, mm-hmm. You know. Mm-hmm. But that was, if it wasn't for that, I would never watch it.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah.
Yeah.
Everybody knows Ross is my baby daddy.
Yeah, so this really brought... Girl, I don't want to see... I got into a lot just now, but I don't want to get too much into it because we'll be here all day, all night, and I can't. But yeah, so it brought up a lot about colorism, a lot about mixed people and things like that. Oh, one thing, though. This is the thing with Dana Lay, right? I actually enjoy her music.
I'm glad I'm not a fan.
And it was really disappointing for me that mm-hmm. this whole thing happened. So I really enjoyed her music, and I know that she's Dominican, and I'm one of the ones that says that Dominicans are black, or most of them are black, or that, well, I say that there is a such thing as black Dominicans. And you know, so that's what I will like go off of. And honestly, I'm gonna come clean though. I wasn't really too sure about Dana Lay. I wasn't. But I pretended because I really liked her music. The same way I pretended with Evelyn Lozada, because I don't even think that they, you know, they love throwing out Afro Latina when it's convenient and when they want to have a rebuttal when someone call their ass out on some valid shit.
Mm-hmm.
So with Dana Lay out, you know, along with Evelyn, I don't be too sure about them. When it comes to the ethnic
of the
sub-Sahara of it all. But, like, I can't fucking pretend with your ass no more, girl, because you done fucked up. The fuck wrong with you? You gotta be, you have to be black and light to be a yellow bone, sis.
You're
Dominican, you mixed up, but...
But
when when I say she's mixed up, I don't think that... I say she's mixed up of like, the Latin and the European or whatever of it all.
Cause yeah, she's mixed up.
People
with that.
Showed me pictures of her parents, and her parents were straight up Latino.
Yes,
I don't see no
nothing else.
Coarse hair, you know. Like, you know, another thing too was that one of the things that I did bring up in the clubhouse. They said that, you know, her parents don't look nothing like no African nowhere, no black nowhere. But I will say this, y'all. I had a roommate in college. She was Dominican. I had a roommate in college, and she looked more so on the J-Lo side of the spectrum.
Okay.
And her brother looked like he could be my brother.
Yeah, you never know.
Yeah. So it's like how black people can have like all types of shades, and you know, we can grab from, we're so versatile in shades and hair tones and stuff. When you're mixed like that, like Dominicans, you can grab from whatever, you know, is in your blood. So maybe mm-hmm. there is along down the line, she probably does have African in her blood, but it's I don't think it's to the point where like you identify as a black person. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know a girl. I went to high school with a girl, and she's fully Dominican, both parents Dominican, but she has like blonde hair. You would think she was just a white girl.
Yeah.
But she had blonde hair, and but then her parents, they just look like Latinos. Mm-hmm. You just know that they're, you know, of Latin descent or whatever. But she doesn't really look like them that much. She said her grandmother had like full head of blonde hair. Mm-hmm. She looks exactly, if you look at pictures of her grandmother, mm-hmm. twins. So like it's just a you can pull. What her parents look like? They just look like Spanish people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. So it's just one of those things. And also, y'all had Cardi B trending today, trying to say that she's another Dani Lay. And she's not. Cardi B is Dominican, but she's black. Have you seen that hair? Have you seen that hair?
She's a black one.
And the thing is, like, mind you, Cardi B, her dad is Dominican, not her mom. Her mom is from Trinidad. And that's a whole other thing.
That is true, yeah.
So her mom is black. Her mom is light-skinned. Her mom is light-skinned. But her mom can very well be black mixed with whatever other European, whatever. Because mm-hmm. I'm half Trinidadian, and I know that we got some stuff mixed up with them. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, you know, like I said, Cardi B can grab any sort of trait or whatever, but Cardi B is black. She's Dominican, but she's black enough. Say that she's black enough. Cause have you seen that damn hair? She's black enough. Okay, her hair look like mine.
Yeah,
she's black enough. Ooh, Lord, cause
Cardi B black.
Taylor, girl, them clubhouse rooms this weekend, child.
I didn't get on all this weekend.
They was getting into like being mixed in
and
black.
I was being pinged all weekend. I did not get on at all.
Being mixed in black and, oh, do you consider mixed people black people? I'm like, that's the one thing, though. That's one dumbass thing that I don't like when people say, oh, do you consider mixed people black people? If they're mixed with black, then they're
whatever
black.
They're mixed with, that's what they
Me
are.
Saying, if them being mixed and saying that they're black does not take away from them being mixed with other things.
No.
They're black,
it just
though.
Means they're also black, they're also yeah. white, they're also whatever. Like, that's what that means. That's stupid. Oh, I was being pinged like shit, but with Clubhouse, I have to be... Clubhouse is one of those things where if I get on, I don't get off for hours.
Yeah.
So it's like, you got to be...
Mentally prepare yourself.
You got to mentally prepare yourself. Whatever errands you had to run or do for the day, all that shit got to be out the way. If it's not, then don't get on because you will be on there forever.
I mean, well, I don't mind doing things while I'm on there. I'll drive and do shit like that when I'm on Clubhouse. Because it's like, whatever, I'll put my Bluetooth on, whatever. But I will say... one thing, though. Remember that... convo from last episode, we talked about Jules and Sky Jackson mm-hmm. and how in the texting, he said something about dark ass bitch or whatever the fuck we said, So I posted the clip on YouTube or whatever, and some dumbass, I don't know if it was a kid or somebody, I don't fucking know, they were stupid as hell. I deleted the comments because it was too dumb. I ain't with that shit on my thing. But they were in the comments and saying like, yeah, Beyonce's not black. They're mixed. They're not pro black. Cause when we talked about how Jewel said dark ass bitch, and I said that Beyonce and her family they're all pro black. It's like, oh, they're not pro black. They're mixed. So they, first of all, you don't know what words mean.
First of all, none of that made sense.
You don't know what words mean. First of all, second of all, they are black people. Yeah, they're Creole and whatever, but they're black.
They're still black.
Beyonce's dad is clearly very black.
But her mom
is black. Her mom just might be Creole, but they're all black.
And her daddy black.
What?
But how you gonna say they're not black? No, they're mixed. They're not pro-black.
They don't know what the fuck they're talking about. They don't know what shit means. I had to delete it. I'm like, I don't want this dumbass shit on our comments.
That don't even make sense. Yeah, it's like, shut the fuck up.
Who the fuck
are
you talking about?
That does not even make sense. That sentence makes no sense at all.
It was really dumb. Incorrect.
Like, shut up.
So, I don't know who kid that was, but
that was a child for sure, because you don't know. Don't speak on something you don't know shit about.
But the thing is, when I'm on YouTube, they're strict about kid shit. So, when I upload videos on YouTube, they make me check the box saying, like, oh, is this for kids or it's not for kids? They hide certain shit from kids. So, I don't know who the fuck that was.
But, you know, it'll ask you if you're 18 or over or whatever. YouTube will ask you when you, like, sign up or whatever. Mm. And people lie. You can easily lie.
Okay.
I've been lying since I don't know when.
Oh.
Or shit like that. So that's all that is. They lied and said they were 18. They're probably like 12.
Oh, yeah. Like, you know, they're not pro-black. They're mixed.
Yeah, it'll ask you how old you are. And you have to click an age. Or, like, put in your birthday or whatever the fuck you have to do to prove you're 18 or over. But they probably lied and said they were 18 or not.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, that didn't make any sense.
That's all that was. Yeah. They really don't verify it.
Yeah. Yeah, that's all I have to say about that. Yeah, I'm just like, you know, Angela Yee, like, I wish you would just go out a little bit harder on certain things. And Charlamagne and Envy were being very dismissive on the topic.
And I don't like
and
that.
Not really fully thinking about the issue. Like, you bringing up Beyonce's brown skin girl didn't really make any sense if you really think about it. It didn't. You bringing up Childish Gambino's song,
it
Red
doesn't.
Bone.
It's not helping your case.
It really didn't make any sense
it's
if
not
you really
helping
think about
case.
It. You know what I'm saying? So,
Those are completely different things.
And then also, Dani Lay took that clip and, like, posted it on her page and put period on it. Like, bitch, you don't understand you don't get it.
I'm glad I'm not a fan of her.
You don't fucking get it. So we'll see, girl. I like I said, because she would say nigga in her songs, and I'm gonna come clean. I would pretend that she's part black because she was Dominican. Like, she Dominican. She had a little African. Her hair curl up just enough.
All right, yeah, cool, but now cool.
Now I can't fucking fake it no more, bitch. Because you doing dumb shit.
She's gonna lose a lot of like fans. And things.
That's why
like
she posted that damn apology.
Like, that nobody accepted it though.
Yeah, so
everybody in the comments was like, no, we don't
want it. We're gonna see, girl. Oh, girl, damn. I'm gonna have to listen to your songs in private because I don't know. I love her new album. Damn, am I a bird for that?
I don't want to think you're a bird because I don't like, okay,
for instance, I can't pretend no more with you. I can't pretend no more with you, bitch.
Did you stop listening to Tory Lanez?
Girl, yeah, I deleted all his songs off my playlist.
I didn't delete them, I just don't play them. But I should delete them.
No, I listen to them. I curate my own personal playlist.
I still
playlist.
Have R. Kelly on my phone, but I don't listen to him at all.
Oh, I curate my own personal playlist. So that's what I do.
I just, mine just be on like a radio and I'll skip it if I just skip it if they come on or whatever, but I don't play them niggas. I just never. It's not even that I don't want to delete now. R. Kelly, at first I was like, oh my God, I want to delete that
like
shit.
You're right.
But, because I was like, but like Tory Lanez, like right. It's not that I don't want to delete you. I just didn't take the time to go delete it.
Okay.
Because I had to start listening to him, so I added a lot of stuff. So now I have to go sit there and like.
On Spotify, all I do is go to my playlist, type in Tory in the search, and it'll bring up all the songs I have on my playlist of him, and I just click the minus sign. Boom.
Yeah, I just don't feel like doing it.
Yeah. So.
But yeah. I ain't gonna say you a bird for it, but
now I can't pretend that you at least a little black bitch. I can't do it no more. I can't.
When I watched the impressive video.
Girl, listen to them, Taylor. I was hanging on at any thread. I was like, okay, her hair is curly. Okay, cool. Her hair's curly. All right. Bet. Yeah, my old roommate was Dominican. Her brother, like he was real, real black. So they gotta have some black in them somewhere. So let me just grab from there. Yeah. I was literally trying to like. She I can't pretend up. With you no more, bitch. I can't.
She when I watched the impressive video, it was a post and she was like, what, like saying like, I'm Dominican, I'm black and I'm white and da, 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 and it's like, oh, now so you want to claim
all this other shit that made me down in the lineage. I guess her old like high school classmates was saying some shit saying about how like, oh, she called somebody a dirty Haitian or some shit like that. The whole Haitian Dominican divide.
Yeah, child.
We called somebody a dirty Haitian one time and like it was two people that said something from high school.
Danny called me an ugly Haitian in fifth grade, so no, she doesn't get to claim blackness all of a sudden. Thanks to the neighborhood talk.
Damn, bitch. Well,
you fucked that up, babe. You did that with this, and then you did it all for a song that no one even likes.
You did it all for a fake song. The song was fake. It wasn't a real song, bitch. You recorded it real quick because you was mad.
It's not like she went like this on her phone and
she
just
did.
Like, yeah,
I know
like,
she did.
With a beat in the background, just like, all right, put that shit out. Like, what? That shit is horrible. It's so bad.
Yeah, at least make it sound.
At least make it sound good.
Like, though. You didn't even write that down. You just said it in the studio.
Mm-hmm. It's not even a full song.
It's not a song at all. It's fake. It's all fake.
You just said like the same word 10 times and made a cut.
Like you just had to find something.
And
that,
she was like, you know, you would have thought that this is like the best song in the world.
And they had the baby comment in the comments
with
like,
the yellow.
No, he emojis. He be trying to make her feel better. Like he be trying because he's tied up. But he
looks stupid commenting though. You just making it worse. You look dumb.
It's fine. You know, one thing that really saved me when it came to DaBaby, it saved me because he has beautiful dark-skinned daughters, and he always uplifts them.
He does.
He always says how beautiful
but
his daughters are.
But don't back her for that shit. I don't care if that's your girl, but he didn't tell her she's
wrong.
But
he a nigga, and I'm not defending him at all. So what you're saying is very true, very valid. What I'm saying is what saved me was him always uplifting his brown daughters.
He does.
Is that, and
that.
Also, like, these niggas is the main reason why bitches do that shit. Because they always uplift the light girls.
We always say, that is the mother, these are the mothers of your children.
Mm-hmm.
So you shouldn't let your current girl be talking shit about them. Like, she's talking shit to the world about the mother of your child pretty
no,
much.
No, I mean, she wasn't being, like, direct.
I know, but nip that shit in the bud still.
Yeah, I do feel like it should have been like a weird thing for him to, for like, girl, what you mean? Because my kids are beautiful.
Yeah, like,
chocolate.
What you trying to say? Like, you know.
Yellow bonus, what he want, what he want.
No, you're just, he wants
so,
convenience.
Well, the post has been deleted. And
he wants convenience.
Apologies were made. So I'm going to either Stop listening to Danny Lay or listen to it in the car.
That should be the title. Myself. Convenience. That's what he want.
Oh.
That's how I feel. It's just convenient.
Because deadass, he was with Mimi like the previous month. Anywho, moving along. So that's that, y'all. If y'all want to join Clubhouse, go ahead and do the thing. It was a really good weekend, full of good content, full of good enlightenment, all those good things. We should start a Clubhouse room one day.
Ooh, yes.
Yeah, we should.
I'm here for that.
So moving along, because we've been talking about this, Lord. Anywho, two quick things. Did you see how Bow Wow, it was some promo clip of Growing Up Hip Hop of Bow Wow bragging about how he's going to be talking about all the bitches that he fucked on in a new album.
Yeah, I didn't even care about
He brought up Black China, brought up Keisha Cole. I'm like, wow, yeah. Y'all, you are really a whole ass nigga. You're a whole weirdo.
It's just
you're
his name
weirdo.
In people's mouths. So
yeah,
because
like no one's
it.
Gonna, no one cares about you. You can't make a regular album because no one. You need a scandal. You need
That's
shock.
The
you
thing.
Need a shock value behind your album because no one's gonna care otherwise. But what you're doing is corny as fuck.
Because the last time people were talking about Bow Wow, he was lying about being on a private jet.
Yeah.
Or some shit like that. Like
when
it's
they,
always
when they
bullshit.
Post his beautiful daughter.
Yeah, when they do like TikTok dances and shit, people are like, oh, this is cute, you know, whatever. But like, just you, if you drop an album right now, nobody.
And you performing in Houston and that whole crowd, like, first of all, why is Houston doing this? Houston
and
is wide
had
open.
On mask.
Club appearances all on top of each other.
Nobody
what
had on a
fuck?
Mask. Now it was. I saw like a few little.
I see Erica Banks out and about too at clubs and stuff. I'm like, y'all nasty.
And then when they get COVID, they're gonna be sitting there talking
y'all
about they
nasty.
Bored in the house. Child.
You know Malik from the game. What was his name? Josiah Sanchez or
some shit like that.
Yeah, he tweeted some shit. He was like, you know, basically y'all need to stop getting booked for these clubs because y'all go to these clubs and have everybody come out to go see you and get sick, get at risk of getting sick, and then you go home to your mansion with your premium health care, your money,
yep.
Your big bag that you got from
he
that
right.
Parents. Like, what the fuck? Why are you?
That's
why
the
y'all
best
doing
thing
this?
I ever heard Malik say. Because, you know, he a little cocky nigga. That's the best thing I ever heard him say.
So, yeah, Bow Wow's a weirdo, per usual. And then also, one more thing. So, I guess Lil' Kim really, really wants Teyana Taylor to play her in a biopic.
Yeah.
So, here's the thing about Lil' Kim, right? First of all, I still don't think it was a good reason why she was mad at Notori for depicting her in that Biggie movie. Like, she did a great job, honestly.
I thought she did really good.
I think that she was mad because she was dark-skinned. I think she was mad that Notori was dark skin. What do you think?
I don't know if she was mad. I don't know.
Maybe because the way that they wrote her in.
Maybe that's why. Yeah. But like that's not Notori's fault. She's doing a damn job.
Yeah.
Of what they told her to, you know.
Yeah.
Depict on
she
there.
Didn't write the script.
But I do think she picked Teyana Taylor because one reason. Remember when it was like one of them hip hop
awards.
The VH1
hip hop honors.
Yeah. When she you know. Was she did the whole tribute to Lil' Kim. Teyana did a great job.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not mad that she wants her to play her.
But they don't look... Teyana's not a... Is Teyana short?
I think she's kind of tall. She looks tall to me. She always looks tall and thin to me.
I don't know why. Lil' Kim, she's very...
Lil' Kim was like 5'2".
Do you think that she's delusional sometimes? I don't know. One thing that bothers me about Lil' Kim, and oh, big ups to her, she's a legend. But one thing that bothers me about her is that when she talks about the new rap girls, she can never talk about someone without complimenting herself. She always has to bring herself into something.
I think Lil' Kim is very sensitive.
It's very self-centered.
She is.
Like, she wants to big up the new girls, but she wants to remind you that she birthed them, I guess. I don't know. It's just weird.
Yeah,
every time
she
talks about a new girl.
And I hate it because Lil' Kim is one of my faves. Like, I can sing some Lil' Kim songs wherever. Right now, I love Lil' Kim, so I don't want you to be like that. Like, okay, give them their props and whatever, but you ain't gotta always throw yourself in there and remind everybody
like
that it wasn't for you.
Yeah, like she reminds me of me. Like Malala cannot remind you of you. How does Malala remind you of you? How does Make the Same Mind remind you of you? How?
Every one of them cannot remind
you.
That's
all the time. Every time that she talks about a new girl, it's always, yeah, I did this. Yeah, I remember she, oh yeah, yeah, I remember I did this too. And she, yeah, that she did the same thing I did.
And it's not about you all the time. So I wish she would stop doing that.
I mean, like I said, you know, big ups to you. You did birth a lot of these girls. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm not taking that from you, but you don't have to.
And no shade. I was watching Zach Campbell, and he had somebody, Malibu Dollface or something like that.
What?
I don't know. He had a guest on his show, and
that's somebody's name, Malibu Dollface?
A YouTuber. I think okay. that's what his name is. And they were talking about, it was years ago. It was when the whole Cardi B fight thing happened.
Oh, yeah.
And he said, you can't spell Nicki Minaj without K-I-M. And I was like, ooh. Well, oh, that's right.
He ain't. I know. Where's the lie? Okay. He ain't lying. But, I mean, so, yeah.
But, yeah, I just, that's one thing about, I don't know. But, girl, I mean, I guess, you know, one of these days we will get a full-blown, like a full-length Little Kimberly Jones Lifetime biopic.
I mean, and it better be immaculate.
I'd rather be on VH1 because they've been doing good with the TLCs. And please don't let it be on Lifetime. I want, girl, because Lifetime. They put that I didn't watch it. They just released that damn salt and pepper shit on Lifetime. I'm not planning on watching that. I don't think I'm gonna
watch. I thought it. I was, but I don't want to now.
And then it was that, and then also like it's about to be a Wendy Williams. I guess they didn't have Spinderella in the movie either, and then she was mad about that.
She was mad. Yeah, she already doing interviews. So. She was on interviews. I saw an interview like same day, of the shit when the shit came out. But I was gonna watch it, but now I don't want to. And then
I'm not mad though. I'm not watching Wendy Williams. I think I may watch the Wendy one because like not. It's Wendy Williams, and I'm gonna just see.
I said I was gonna see about some. I'm not because. Wendy Williams.
And I heard it's 2 hours, too. I'm not watching that shit for 2 hours.
Oh, yeah, I'm not. I'm not doing it.
If it was on VH1 and you had Spinderella in it, yeah, maybe. Because also, I caught wind of their, they did a Breakfast Club interview to promote the movie, mm-hmm. Salt and Pepper, and they said that they couldn't even use all their songs in the movie. So I'm like, I don't want to watch this.
Why couldn't you?
I don't want to watch this, no.
Well, okay, if we get a Lil' Kim one, I would love for it. I want VH1 to do it, and I want it to be done right.
Yeah.
I don't, because, like, remember,
And get someone realistic to play her. We have seen
some horrible-ass biopics in the past, and I don't want that again.
I've seen horrible ones from Lifetime, not from VH1.
No, yeah, it was always Lifetime, but yeah. I'm just saying, like, just give me a, VH1, keep it up and do a good one because I don't want no bullshit. Like, mm-hmm. It's Lil' Kim. Let me enjoy it. VH1 is no good.
Because I would really love to see, like, a more of her background depicted in a movie.
Or who, when they did No Audition Story, where they came out on VH1?
Yeah, of course. Yeah,
VH1. So, yeah.
Oh, no, sorry.
Oh, no, that was BET because they have it on BET Plus.
Oh, you know what? Yeah. So, yeah, either BET or VH1.
That's whoever did No Audition Story and Bobby Brown, like,
That was BT.
Give me a Lil' Kim story.
That was BT, but TLC did VH1 did TLC. That was good.
The TLC one was good. But then people start pointing out little stuff, and they would have, like, when they would be at the club, it would be, like, Ciroc in the background and shit like that. And I was just like, y'all petty. Ooh. But you got to pay attention to them little details. Ooh. You have to. Yeah. Yeah. I remember that. It was a whole bottle of Ciroc. I hate
when y'all get clocked like that.
I'm just like, y'all petty, but you gotta watch that shit.
Tyler Perry fall from grace when they had that, they still had that.
I was just talking about that ass straight bitch.
They was eating ass straight bitch.
I was just talking about that
when they was eating air and drinking air.
Yes, like, and it was a good movie. Like the plot itself was good. It was a good movie. The plot and everything was good. Okay. That's what I mean. Okay. But it's just that it wasn't executed.
You know what? I ain't gonna hold you. The movie was alright. Like, the whole stuff, the 2929 Sycamore Street, whatever, that whole thing, and it being like some, like...
The plots be good for the most part. It's just that the execution is not always as well as it should be.
Yes. Yes.
That's the thing.
Yes.
Tyler Perry got work on your execution, brother. I'm still here for you, though. Cause, like, you're amazing.
He damn near owns BET.
I want to go to Tyler Perry Studios.
Cut on BET. I bet you it was a damn. It's either Baby Boy or Tyler Perry. Movie.
Everything he's ever done is on BET Plus. Everything.
I think he owns BET Plus. At this point, I think he owns like a share in BET. I don't know.
He probably does because all his shit is on it. Everything. Yeah. Down to the plays. Everything.
Yeah. It
that
is.
That got his name on it.
I heard they remade House of Pain and it's trash.
It's like another reboot. It's called. I forgot what it's called, but I didn't watch House of Pain like that. Cause it was something about his sitcoms. They just seemed like corny to me. And then even when all his shows, like Have and Have Nots, and that's a good fucking show. I'm not caught up on
Girl,
it.
But I would never.
Show. But no, that show, if you like One Life to Live and shit like that with a bunch of damn tea and drama, it's good. But a lot of those, even if you look at, just look at the show itself, it looks like whatever camera they use is like, not a good camera sometimes and things like that. And that bothers me because I'm like, why does it look bootleg?
And I hate that I know and that I can tell that you shot this in 5 days. I hate that.
Yeah, I shouldn't be able to. If you did it in 5 days, I shouldn't know it. That means you need to stop doing that and you need to take time and sit down.
But he's writing he has all these shows and movies and scripts that he writes all of his scripts.
Yeah, he's too. When he has a new show coming, he will take a picture of the script and like post it on Instagram.
Yeah.
Like, I just want him the execution to be better. Like, because you've been in the game for a while now. You should know better. I know you started with plays, but you got enough movies out.
He refuses to work with other writers. That's what it is. he has an issue with working with other writers and things like that. And also one thing though, that kind of triggers me a bit is the Madea thing. I love Madea, but the whole like idea and that whole depiction, it just kind of triggers me a bit.
He said he knew somebody like that. And so that's where it comes from.
Of course, of course.
So he's writing about,
but
like,
of course, but it's still, it's very triggering for me. It brings up a lot of stereotypes, and I think it kind of I don't know, personifies. I don't know if I'm saying this right, but it kind of like dehumanizes like the Black woman to me.
I see why you say that.
Like it gives like a caricature or some sort when it comes to Black women. Being aggressive and being this and that or whatever. And then also, he has a lot of, like, colorism situations in his movies and shit, too. Like, it's always some dark-skinned, like, bad guy and, like, the light-skinned, like, suffering one, the sensitive one, or the one that's graceful. Or, like, a lot of times it's, like, the man, the dark-skinned man leaves his brown-skinned wife for the light-skinned woman. And, like, in Acrimony, like, with Taraji P. Henson, like, he had a new wife and she was light-skinned and stuff. Even though Taraji left him or whatever, but, like, he got a new wife and he's rich. He's rich now. He has a new wife and his new wife.
Yeah, everything he's supposed to give Taraji, this light-skinned bitch, then got it. And, like,
you know what I'm saying? So it's a lot of those situations in his movies, though. It's a lot of that in his movies. So
he should think about that.
Yeah. And then also with the Oval, even though the Oval is like, it's so bad, it's hilarious.
I refuse to watch
like
that.
The wife, the first lady, like she's this like fucking devil. Like she's this fucking demon. Like she's crazy.
So I'm saying again, ever since that damn first scene when they was fighting like ninjas.
I'm dead. They were. Like, it was really like...
In the Oval Office, y'all fighting like ninjas. What the fuck is going on?
Like, y'all going in.
And they supposed to be getting dressed to do whatever the fuck.
I gotta watch Oval. I stopped watching it. Love Paige Hurd. She did her best.
I love Paige Hurd.
That's the thing. It's not the act. The acting isn't bad.
It's the execution of the projects. That's what it is.
Yeah. Anywho, I'm sorry. No shade. I get so scared talking about that.
No, like, I love Tyler Perry. I admire him a lot.
So that, do you have any topics that you want to discuss before we get into the music and stuff?
No, I don't.
So let's get into the shows real quick though before the music.
Yes.
Did you catch that Ashanti Kitchiko Bat versus Battle Girl?
Girl, it was ghetto.
Ooh, girl, yes. And I know that it was, first of all, I'm upset.
And I love y'all. I'm
upset because we could have had the full effect if Ashanti ain't get COVID.
First off, let's say that.
So I'm mad about that, but I know that it was kind of upsetting because they had to do that damn fucking cropped up ass split screen bullshit.
And if you're watching on Instagram, you can't see Keisha at all because she was on the bottom.
Yeah, so it was that, and then also it was kind of some weird energy between them. I guess Keisha Cole came on the set over an hour late, and so come to find out, she was upset from the quality of the video. She felt like it was looking too blurry.
Mm-hmm.
She was mad that the music wasn't sounding a certain way, and she was upset.
She kept telling them cut the music up or down.
She should have been a good sport and sat there because she was over an hour late. And Shanti was sitting there trying to like.
And she said that she was like, basically she was so pissed off about that she had to get herself together to then come out. But you should have just sucked that shit up and sat her down. Y'all were both already late to begin with.
Because the momentum is already dead because it's been like a two weeks late.
You should have just sucked it up and eventually your mood would change, you know, once you get into singing and whatever. And then they had another take a damn break. I was like...
A break? Yeah, because it's 20 songs. So that's what they do.
You sound like Soulja.
That's what they do. Yeah, that's what it's about.
But it was just annoying.
Songs.
But I just feel like after all that time passed, you already had to rush the end of it. Like, you shouldn't have took no break. Your break was an hour and a half, sis.
Oh yeah, she was upset.
I just thought that was really disrespectful.
And you saw how her and Shanti got like
low key. I was like,
a little situation because Keisha Cole, she did play after Shanti was like, this is it or whatever, take the break or whatever. Keisha Cole went and played another song, an extra song.
Yeah, she did.
So she did. So it was Ashanti's turn to go.
Yeah, she was like, no, so I'm going to go. And Keisha was like, so I'm about to start. She was like, no, you're not. And I'm like, don't let her take your turn, sis.
And Ashanti said that she tried to get Ja Rule to come through. That would have been cool.
Yeah, I would have liked to see Ja Rule.
Girl, I screamed when she had OT Genesis popping.
I was cracking up. Because, baby, that man can that sing, Chad.
Mm-hmm.
That man can that sing.
If this whole thing happened when it was supposed to, Ja Rule would have came out. Diddy would have came out for that. Because Last Night is my shit.
Man. Listen, they played... Do you think anybody won? Or do you think
I think that Ashanti and even though because I looked it
I'm
up,
I'm giving it a tie.
A tie because I looked it up. Keisha Cole, her debut album came out 3 years after Ashanti's, I think, and So that's not too big of a difference. But mm-hmm. I don't know. I just feel like Ashanti's stuff, because Ashanti, she was a writer as well too, and she told the story how she almost got signed to Bad Boy and this and that or whatever. She was writing stuff first before she even came out. So I feel like Ashanti is like another era for me. Even though it's not too far off from Keisha's, I feel like Ashanti's another era for me.
I don't
me.
Feel like that.
Because I feel like Ashanti was very much... I remember more Ashanti stuff when I was in elementary school, but I remember more Keisha stuff when I was in middle school. You know
that's
what I'm
true,
saying?
But I don't... That's very true, but I don't feel like it's a different era at the same time because it was so close together.
That's what I said. Like, I feel like... But I'm just like... I associate them with different times in my life. Yeah. I'll say that.
I think Ashanti... As far as her vocals, I think they have grown a lot. I do. Like, I mean, I never thought she never don't have, like, I didn't think she didn't have a voice at all. Mm-hmm. But I can just see how it's grown from where she, from when she started to now. Mm-hmm. I see a lot of growth. So I was happy to see that.
It was some shit that, I think Lyra Galore said some shit about how she can't sing or some shit like that. I'm like, what the fuck?
She said Ashanti can't sing?
Mm-hmm. That was strange.
Why?
That was weird.
What beef do y'all have?
I don't know.
But anyway, I forgot what the fuck I was about to say. I think if to choose a side, I love both of them. But if I had to pick a side, if I absolutely had to, I would pick Keisha because I relate to both of their music a lot. But Keisha is just my girl. Like, it's something about Keisha Cole music just sends me. I just love Keisha music. Just make me feel like, I feel like I'd be channeling her and she'd sing love or something. I feel like I'm sitting in the window while it's raining.
That's the thing with Keisha. With Keisha, I feel so, like I said, R&B, that deep R&B will get my emotions going. And with Keisha, she digs in deep to me. Like she dig in real deep and I'm like, I don't want to go that deep, sis.
See, that's why you have to learn how to, because I can listen to it without being sad. It depends what mood I'm in at that time. If I'm in a happy mood, it don't matter if it's a song about having your heart broke to pieces. Child, I'm going to sing shout out that song and be happy as shit because that's my song. You just got to know how to disassociate with those feelings at the same time if it's a song that you really relate to. Mm-hmm. So it just depends. But child, I could sing some R&B music all damn day and be happy as hell.
Yeah. Okay, so then one last thing from me when it comes to shows and stuff. Just bring this up. So Hulu is premiering a Britney Spears documentary called Framing Britney Spears. So I guess it's going to talk about how the problems that she had with her dad, because her dad is in charge of her estate.
Yeah,
I guess,
I keep saying everywhere free like Britney. Yeah. I get emails from some company found my email and they be like emailing me to buy free Britney merch.
I might get that shit, actually.
I might, actually. I
love my Britney merch.
I keep thinking about it.
Yeah, so they're talking about the issues that she's had with her father and, like, her estate and things like that. So I'm looking forward to that. I love a Britney documentary.
I'm watching it.
No Britney documentary has ever disappointed me.
No.
Because she's had a couple.
No, yes.
I think E had a Britney Spears documentary at one point. They sure did. I think it was called Britney Jean or something like that. Or Britney something.
Britney Jean. It was good. No, I'm going to watch it. I'm watching it. And I know Britney Spears.
He used to do a lot of good documentaries, actually.
Yeah, I know. I miss those
they
days.
They did a Lindsay Lohan one, too. That was pretty good.
I miss those things.
What happened to E! Documentaries? What was it called? What was it called? E! Something?
E! True Documentary or something like that.
Yeah, E! True Story.
E! True Story.
Yeah. What happened to E! True Stories?
I don't know.
I miss E! True Stories.
I'm going to say it on the cable remote when we finish to see what happens. Bet. This is YouTube.
Okay. Yeah, so I'm going to watch this. So it's coming out on
Hulu. I watched E! True Hollywood Story.
Yes.
That's what it was.
Yes. I miss those. Those
were really good. I used to stay watching it.
Yeah, so Framing Britney is going to premiere on Hulu. It says premieres on Hulu and FX Networks on February 5th.
Oh, it's around the corner.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I'm watching. Yeah. But after that comes out, whenever we're recording in, it will have been watched.
I'm going to buy some Britney shirts.
Yeah, free Britney. Free her.
Yeah.
Hashtag free Britney.
Yeah.
That you said that was all for your
shows? Yes, my shows, yes.
Okay, so. I got a quick little 2-3 things.
Okay, what is it, child?
All right, so. First off, they just dropped yesterday King Kong versus Godzilla movie trailer.
What the fuck? Who's in that?
King Kong Godzilla.
Who's in it?
I don't know.
I mean, the main...
Well, you know, they have King Kong movies and they have Godzilla. Now these bitches about to fight. They didn't say why. It's coming out in February, I think. But I love King Kong movies and I love Godzilla movies. Mm-hmm. So, put them together. I'm here for that shit. The trailer just dropped. It look epic. It really does. Because, you know, Godzilla and King Kong is old as shit. But, like, now we got way better graphics and things. Mm-hmm. So, anywho, There's a movie coming out starring Daniel Kaluuya.
What? What in the movie?
And Lakeith Stanfield Finance.
Oh, that Black Panther
Judas
movie?
And Black Judas and the Black Messiah. Yeah. I'm trying to see that. So, for those who don't know, it's set back in the, what was that like? The Black Panther days.
60s?
Yeah, I'll say 60s.
50s and 60s
or whatever.
Girl, no, no, and, look, look that up. We gotta be accurate with that.
You're right, because it is Black Panther. Let me look up Daniel Kaluuya. It'll be out next month. I think they said the 12th.
What's it called?
Judas and the Black Messiah.
Judas and Black Messiah. Offered a plea deal by the FBI, William O'Neill infiltrates the Illinois chapter of the Black Panther Party to gather intelligence and on Chairman Fred Hampton. All right, Hampton.
Fred Hampton is played by Daniel, and William is played by Lakeith.
Okay.
So, yeah, that's going to be, I think that's going to be pretty good.
The late 1960s.
Okay, so late 60s.
Fred Hampton. Chairman of the Black Panther Party in the late 1960s. This is in his portrayal at the hands of William O'Neill. The film stars Daniel Kaluuya and Lakeith Stanfield as Hampton and O'Neill.
Isn't it true that has a crush on Daniel?
Huh?
Don't you have a crush on Daniel?
Kaluuya?
Yeah.
He fine.
I don't get fine.
I like him.
I like him with facial hair.
Really?
When
see
he
that.
Has the facial hair,
I gotta see that.
He has. I want to say he has it in this movie. I like him with facial hair. It works for him a lot. Because, you know, in Get Out, he didn't have none.
Girl, I was playing, my cousin, Shayla, she's starting her own YouTube channel, and we were doing a mukbang the other day, actually.
What y'all eat?
And, girl, some seafood, I had some shrimps and some crab legs on us. Yeah, so, we were doing it, what the fuck is this? We were doing a mukbang, and, one of the things, when we were doing, like, an F, Mary, Kill thing, so we said, I think we said, F, Mary, Kill, Michael B. Jordan, Michael Ealy or Lakeith Stanfield.
Oh my God, that's
so my cousins and my sister was like, oh yeah, marry Michael Ealy, F Lakeith Stanfield and kill Michael B. Jordan. I'm like, F Lakeith, what the fuck y'all talking about? And so she thinks that he's so fine. Like, Lakeith is weird. I've seen his interview, he is weird as fuck.
First of all, I would marry Michael B. Jordan.
I'm marry Michael Ealy.
I think I'd marry Michael B. Jordan.
I know I'd marry Michael.
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. Michael Ealy, I might kill him.
Why, bitch?
And I might fuck Lakeith.
Fuck Lakeith?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think Lakeith is very interesting.
Because Michael Ealy's just older. Like,
I think he would be very interesting to talk to, Lakeith. But he's just kind of weird a little bit.
I don't want
to
marry him. Yeah, I don't want to marry him, though. I would just like to fuck him.
I don't want to talk to him on this podcast.
He'd be cool to talk to as well. Mm-hmm. Yeah, in general. I think he'd be really, I think he's probably, like, really cool. He is a weirdo, though. I've seen his interviews.
Yeah.
But it's, like, in a funny way. He just real goofy and weird.
It's in an alarming way to me.
But, yeah, I was going to say what the movie's about, but Daniel already said it.
Yeah.
Kong and Godzilla, I'm sorry. It's Millie Bobby Brown is in it. I did forget to say that.
I know there's some humans in it.
Yeah, but I just didn't know everybody. She was the only person I saw that I recognized. Mm. Anywho, lastly, have you seen that movie? They just put it on Netflix, but it came out. I don't know when it came out, but it came out on Netflix. It's called Cutthroat City.
No, what's that about?
Okay, so it's starring Denzel Whitaker. You know, Forrest Whitaker's son, Shameik Moore.
Denzel Whitaker. He had a son.
Yeah, they look exactly alike.
Let me see. I don't know. It's called Cutthroat. What?
Cutthroat City. Denzel Whitaker was in The Great Debaters. He was that little fat boy. On The Great Debaters.
Wait, let me see. Hold on, because I've probably seen this little ass.
You've seen him before.
Cutthroat City. Oh, that's the nigga from Euphoria in it. The white boy. Oh,
yeah, the boy Daniel.
Moore. Oh, that's Forrest Whitaker's son?
Yeah.
I never knew that shit. Oh, is T.I. in this?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Is
Girl,
it good?
Isaiah Washington.
Is it good? It's trash?
No, it wasn't trash. I think the movie was a little dragged out, and I think that, you know, it was based in Louisiana after Katrina happened. So I think that
it says RZA produced it.
RZA, he directed it.
Directed it.
Yeah.
Lord.
And so it was based right after Hurricane Katrina hit. And the four main characters that I just named, they are all best friends. But they live in the hood.
Oh, the nigga that played Tupac in this joint.
Yeah, Demetrius Shipp Jr. They need money real bad. They, you know, to help their family out. And they, you know, FEMA ain't doing, they said the ward, they live in the ninth ward. The ninth ward ain't covered to help them with housing or anything, which is fucked up. So they're like, we got to get this money. So they decided to go on a heist and get this fucking money. So My I have some pros. I have some not Demetrius. Shameik, he did really good. I think he did really good. Some of the actors I feel like could have done better, and I think that the movie was about, it's like 2 hours and some change, and I think it could have been like an hour and a half. It didn't have to be 2 hours. It was kind of dragged out. And I also think that some people, since you're supposed to be from Louisiana, I need to hear that accent thick. Like I heard a little Louisiana, but I heard mostly Atlanta.
Lord.
And then like they, you could hear them try to put it in there, but it wasn't like how it should be, you know what I mean?
Oh God.
And so that was annoying. And then, oh my God, when they did the heist, girl, these niggas just walk in this place with matching black hoodies and black gloves on and put stocking caps on their faces. Like, you can see through the stocking caps. Why? And, but nobody, no, it was never like, oh, I can see your face. I know who did this. Like, they, I just thought it would look, it just looked so stupid. In real life, you can never just put a stocking cap on your face and go rob an establishment. You know what I mean? It was just annoying. Like, who, you can't go rob a bank with a stocking cap on your face. That shit really pissed me off. It was so annoying. I also heard that, I looked it up and I watched some reviews on it, and someone said that Lil Wayne and Birdman was actually supposed to star in it, but when they had their falling out, that
what the fuck, this movie came out last year.
No, but they've been working on recording this movie for years.
Then there shouldn't be no mistakes like stocking caps and shit and dragging out.
That's what they chose to use. That's not a mistake. To them, that wasn't a mistake.
Terrence Howard in it.
Terrence Howard didn't need to be in that movie either.
They just wanted it. You know, they wanted a big ensemble cast. Yeah.
That's what it was. It was that type of thing, but it wasn't what you would expect it to be with this big cat. Like, Isaiah Washington was in it, and I think you didn't see enough of him. Terrence Howard, maybe if we saw kind of a backstory of how he was in the movie, it would have made more sense why he was in there, you know what I mean? They had other characters and showed everybody's different people's lives, but they didn't show enough of it for you to grasp that character or relate to that character. You saw the person who you saw their life the most was Shameik Moore. His name was Blink. And so, but overall, I liked the movie. I was a little in. Okay, it's another thing. I thought it was like a twist at the end, but then it wasn't the twist, and they kind of confused me. But I'm not going to say why, because, you know, I want you to watch it. But I thought it was weird. I don't even understand the ending yet. You'll see. So I would give that movie like 3 stars.
Three out of 5.
Yeah.
Okay, Wesley Snipes.
Wesley Snipes was Shameik Moore's daddy on it.
I bet he was.
But you didn't see enough of him either. Like, I guess he wasn't around like he was supposed to be, but he needed help.
They probably didn't pay his ass enough. They just wanted him in there for 2 seconds. So we won't pay.
But I was just, I would have loved to see he, because Shameik briefly talked about how he wasn't, his father wasn't there or whatever. Once he went to him for help, but it's like, show that backstory a little bit. They didn't show enough backstory for me either.
Is Wesley Snipes going to be in the Coming to America too?
I believe so.
I think I saw him in the trailer.
I believe so. When is that coming out again?
I forgot.
I need that soon.
I think it's in March. I'm not sure.
But yeah, I'll give it a 3 out of 5. And then I think that was going to be the same for that.
Okay, well.
One more. I'm sorry.
What?
I finished Bridgerton.
Oh, shit. I got to watch. Girl, I still got to watch that still. And I have to watch that. And I got to watch Snowfall.
And P-Valley.
And P-Valley, bitch.
Listen, real quick on Bridgerton. That show is amazing. That show is fucking amazing.
I know. A lot of y'all love it.
Now that I've seen it, it gives me, like, I can really, like, kind of say what I like about it. If Gossip Girl and Downton Abbey had a fucking baby, that's what this show is. Because it's a bunch of mess, and it's just Victorian people and British people and shit. One thing I love about it, because it's those Victorian times when they go to balls and things, you know, they have, like, the orchestra playing the music. But, like, they'll have modern songs. Like, they had Thank You Next playing.
Yeah,
it
was just
it's really cute. I like that. And I liked that there were so many different characters. But just like I said about, what's that movie, Cutthroat City? It was so many characters that everybody didn't get a chance to shine. So you didn't get to relate to everybody because they didn't show everybody enough. And then the girl that played Marina, she's a beautiful girl, great actor. She's a black girl, a little light-skinned, curly-haired black girl. But the only thing that she had going for herself in this whole show was that she had got pregnant by some nigga, and the nigga wasn't around. Because he was fighting for their country. He was, like, out to war. or whatever. But it was just like, why is her only part of the story just being somebody's baby mother? Like, I didn't like that. That man, maybe that's just me. Because it wasn't, it like, the queen is black. She's light-skinned, but she's black. There's the girl Marina. It wasn't that many black people. So I'm like, so the fact that there's not that many and you about to get this girl only part, only story to be pregnant out of wedlock, you know what I'm saying? You know how they were about that shit back then. So that was a whole scandal. I wish there were more dark. I saw like some dark-skinned girls, but they weren't like main people. They were just like some random lady's daughters. So yeah, I wish there were more dark-skinned people. But I do think Shonda Rhimes, she did a really good job for this show. And if y'all saw on the Twitter page, there will be a season two. So I'm excited for that because, you know, they say who Lady Whistledown was at the end. I knew it. I'm just going to say that. I knew it. I called it. By like episode 4, I knew. Anyway, that's all I'm going to say. I give it a 4 out of 5, though.
I cannot.
4 out of 5. I'm about to start giving ratings or anything now.
Yes. Okay. So on to the music. I don't really have anything that, I just have some critiques. That's all. First though, I want to shout out Van Jess. They just announced that they're dropping their new EP called Homegrown on February 5th. So I can't wait to listen to that full length project.
I'm gonna listen. I love their voices.
And to talk about it on the show. So next, they released the Throat Baby remix featuring DaBaby and City Girls. Yes. And people hated it. But I thought it was, first of all, the video was very vulgar. I saw the DaBaby surfing on cum or some shit like that. That was crazy. But the video effects were great. The video looked good. I'll say the video looked good.
I agree. The video
did
look
good. It was a bit nasty. It was nasty. But the song is called Throat Baby.
So, yeah. I mean, what so you expect? Yeah.
But some people weren't really excited about the City Girls being on it. I don't mind. I don't mind JT's verse. But I think it's. I think that people still need to get used to Carisha's voice. I guess.
I don't mind her voice though. I don't mind her.
Yeah. I mean the remix. It's alright. If you listen to it a couple times, you'll be like, "That's alright. Cool. Whatever. I'm cool. I'll let it play." I wasn't like upset about it like everybody else was, but
yeah, I wasn't. I think it was smart to do a remix because they wore the regular version out. So why not make it a fucking remix?
I think that because JT said on live, she said that she think that the song should have been structured differently. I think they should have had the City Girls in the beginning, and then had DaBaby close out the song.
Maybe,
but they just wanted, you know, they wanted that shock value, so they had to put DaBaby at the beginning. Maybe. But anywho,
I ain't mad at it. It's whatever.
That's that. And then also Rich the Kid just dropped a single called Nasty, and it features Flo Millie, Mulatto, and Ruby Rose. And I brought this up because I love how, you know, they're bringing out a lot of the new, you know, rap girls. And I think this is really, a really cool collaboration that he did with them. I think it's cool that he had all of them on that song. I just think the song is I just think the song is like kind of like lackluster, I think. I don't know. I didn't care for it. I didn't care for it at all. And then also, I think that Flo Millie, I want to hear more versatility from Flo Millie for some reason. I don't know. I just think that, you know, she has a signature voice, just like how Ruby Rose has a signature voice.
Yeah.
But with Flo Millie, I just think that she just needs to do a little bit more, I guess, with her music, just to show a little bit more versatility for me. I don't know. And then, I just think that this song, this collaboration was a bit awkward. I think it didn't really mesh well to me. I'll probably listen to it again just to make sure I'm right. I feel like it just didn't mesh well to me.
Because, like, you can start to sound the same a lot.
Like that song, Roaring Twenties, I didn't bring it up last episode because I didn't like it. I hated the song. I hated it.
I'm not a fan
I didn't feel like it was a real, ooh, God.
They spitting on each other.
Yeah, I didn't feel like it was a real song to me. I didn't feel like it was finished.
And I don't even know why it's called Roaring Twenties.
It just sounds the same as her project before. You know, I don't think that I think that she just needs to, switch it up a little bit more, have more versatility. Mulatto, she's cool. And Ruby Rose, I love her voice. I love her music. But I just feel like, I don't know. I just think this collaboration as a whole, I just feel like it just wasn't cohesive enough for me. It was kind of awkward for me. I'll play for you after we get off the air.
Yeah, I'm going to listen to it.
That's all for me for the music. Do you have any music?
I don't even have any music.
Okay, yeah. Because I haven't really heard anything that I like that much.
I really want to shout out.
Has anyone even released like new shit this year yet? Like new albums yet? I don't know.
We're supposed to get Drake's soon.
Oh, but, yeah, you know, but that's not happening. Back, yeah.
Yeah, so hopefully February or March.
Yeah, okay, we'll see. I'll check out the Van Jess stuff, though.
Yeah, I will. But other than that, no, I don't have anything.
All right, well, you guys, I hope that you guys enjoyed this episode 85. Mm-hmm. You know, remember, you can listen to us on all podcast streaming platforms. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Type in HER D, the podcast. And then also follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Herd the Podcast. Thank you guys so much, and bye.
Skin girls, skin just like pearls. Best thing in the world. I never tried to for anybody else singing.